end on this. It's the book of 2 Peter, the 3rd chapter and the 10th verse. It says, but the day of the Lord will come as a thief in the night, in the which the heaven shall pass away with a great noise, and the elements shall melt with fervent heat, and the earth also, and the works that are therein shall be burnt up. Right? So basically, the day of the Lord is going to come as a thief in the night. So even though the Lord established signs around his coming, basically, there's no one knows the day, all right? So you can't say that there's this day that everything's going to be, you know, that's the day that I got to be ready. No, you don't. As far as you know, there's a time frame whereby when these signs are in effect, that more or less you have to stay ready, all right? It's more of that kind of thing. It's more as if, like, say you were a sportsman, and whatever point in sport you were in, and you fall out of the contract. Your contract basically fulfilled, and once your contract's fulfilled, what do you have left? You basically have you still have agencies you're still in line with, you still have these different things that are out there and all that type of stuff. But guess what? You need to stay ready, all right? You have to hope that your agent is going to go out there and basically establish, you know, a new contract for you, all right? But in order for you to obtain a contract, did that mean you just stop because you ain't playing no more? No. You have to stay ready, all right? And that's the same thing we got to do.
We got to stay ready in this faith, all right? So it says, seeing then that all these things shall be dissolved, it's going to go into that, what manner of person ought you to be in all holy conversation and godliness,
all right? So basically, what type of person are you meant to be in all holy conversation and godliness, all right? Same way the people that take them, remember there's two marks, alright? There's a mark
on the left hand side, which is the mark of the beast, alright? Which is the RFID chip, the physical mark, alright? Which represents the carnal. Remember the Lord made everything in double, alright? Which is the left hand side. But you also have a righteous mark, alright? Which is the mark that was set upon the elect, the chosen of the nation of Israel, alright? And that's
the spiritual mark that's placed upon the men by way of the angels of the Heavenly Father, right, through the spirit of Yahweh Hashem El Shai. So remember those two different marks. When you have someone that's really about the image of the beast, I mean about the mark on the left hand side, they're really, their whole conversation is about the image of the beast. That's why they basically will take the mark. Right, the reason why they take the mark is down to what? The one thing and the one thing only. That basically they
deal with this this beast system on the left hand side.
Right, and in dealing with it on the left hand side, they basically adhere to all the things this system has to offer. That's why, example, Lot said he was vexated by the filthy conversation of the wicked.
Right, how the wicked basically
spoke about, you know, heathenistic things all the time. Right, and that rubbed him the wrong way. So what then with us? We're speaking about righteous things all the time, basically.
That's what we're going to be talking about, right? We ain't going to be talking about no wickedness, right? So that's why Peter
wrote that. He said, what manner of person ought you to be in all holy conversation and godliness? Verse 12, looking for and hasten unto the coming of the day of the Lord, wherein the heavens being on fire shall be dissolved, and the elements shall melt with fervent heat. Nevertheless, we, according to his promise, look for new heaven and a new earth wherein dwelleth righteousness. Alright? And that's, again, if you're really dealing with his word, you're going to be doing what? You're going to be looking for the righteousness of Yahweh Hashem El Shai. That's really what's going to be in your mind. You're going to be looking to and hoping for the new heavens. If you're not, then you're going to be like Lot's wife. Alright? You're basically going to, when the destruction does come, you're going to look back and hope that there's a way you can, you know, you can salvage what you have in this world, all right? So really, that lets you know who's really about you, all right? So with that, man, I pray you're edified. Until next week, say shalom.